Hydrogen atom is our topic today. So we know that hydrogen atom is containing one electron which is revolving in the orbit around the nucleus, and the nucleus is containing only one proton. And we can represent the hydrogen atom like this. This is a proton which is in the nucleus having positive charge, plus E is the charge. This is the electron revolving in the orbit, minus E is the charge. Between this proton and the electron, there is strong attractive force. And for the revolution of the electron around the nucleus, it requires a centripetal force. So we can write the equation, the centripetal force, mv square by r. This centripetal force is provided by which force? There is strong electrostatic attraction. What's the electrostatic force between the electron and proton? We can write it is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. Then magnitude of the charges, E into E divided by R square. One R cancels. So what is mv square? Mv square is equal to E square by 4 pi epsilon 0 R is equation for mv square. We need kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? Half mv square. Okay. So we multiply a half here to get kinetic energy. When you multiply a half here, we'll get 1 by 2 times E square by 4 pi epsilon 0 R. It is equal to E square by 8 pi epsilon 0 r, equation number 1. This equation gives the kinetic energy of the electron revolving in the orbit. Now, from this equation, we can take r, radius. From this, what is the radius? R is equal to E square by 4 pi epsilon 0 mv square. So, we have taken the equation of r that we have to use afterwards, not here. Now, after a few steps, we may have to use this equation. So, we can keep it there. Equation number 2. Okay, now we need potential energy. So between these two particles, the electron and proton, there is strong attractive force. What is potential energy? So in electrostatics, we have seen that. In electric potential, we have seen that. Potential energy is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 by r. So q1 q2 by r. q1 is plus e. q2 is minus e. What is q1 q2? Minus e square. So minus e square by r. 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. Rearranging, minus E square by 4 pi epsilon 0 R is equation for what? Potential energy. This we can give an equation number 3. Okay, equation 1, 2 and 3. We got 3 equations. Now we need total energy. So to get total energy, we have to add kinetic energy and potential energy. So I can say total energy is equal to kinetic plus potential. I need to add these two. Here we can see E square by 4 pi epsilon 0 r is common. Okay, when you add these two, we can take 4 pi epsilon 0 common, e square by 4 pi epsilon 0 r common. Okay, minus also taken outside. Okay, you can take a plus value, plus e square. Now, here inside a bracket, there will be 1 by 2 because 4 pi is taken, so 1 by 2 is left here. Here we have a minus sign, then we have the 1. Okay. 1 by 2 minus 1 is minus 1 by 2. This minus goes outside. Minus 1 by 2 into what is left? E square by 4 pi epsilon 0 r. This will be equal to minus E square by 8 pi. 4 into 2, 8 pi epsilon 0 r. This is the equation for total energy. So we have got 3 equations. First equation for kinetic energy, then potential energy, and this is for total energy. Now, comparing these two, we can say equation number 1 and equation 4, what we can say? Kinetic and potential energy having same magnitude, but there is only sign difference. So, here we have positive sign, here we have negative sign. So, we can summarize like this. We can say kinetic energy is equal to negative of total energy. When you take the negative of this, we will get kinetic energy. And what about potential energy? Potential energy is equal to, when you multiply here by 2, you will get this value. Okay, when you multiply 2 here, 2 and 8 divides and you will get 4 here. Okay, how can you write then? It is equal to 2 times E. So, 2 times total energy is providing potential energy, and negative of total energy is providing kinetic energy. Okay, so we have got equation for total energy, kinetic energy and potential energy. Okay. Now we need to get equation for electron in nth state. According to Bohr atom model, Bohr has proposed that electron can revolve in the orbit, in a particular orbit, when angular momentum should be equal to integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Okay. So that is called Bohr's postulate. According to Bohr's postulate, we can have the equation that is L. L is the angular momentum. L is equal to n h by 2 pi. This is the equation. What is L, angular momentum? So it is a product of mass, velocity and radius, mvr, is equal to nh by 2 pi. We consider a particular orbit. We can say it is nth orbit, nth orbit. For nth orbit, what we will see? We will write m, mass is the same. Velocity in nth orbit, we will give a symbol vn. Radius of nth orbit, we will give a symbol rn. So m, vn, rn is equal to nh by 2 pi. Okay. From this, what is vn? Vn is equal to, I can use the equation nh by, vn is equal to nh by 2 pi m into rn. This I can use equation number 5. I have an equation for velocity in nth or velocity of the electron in nth orbit. Now what about the radius of the orbit? So we have got the equation for radius. For nth orbit, the radius is rn. You can use rn here. What is rn? E square by 4 pi epsilon 0 m v, we have to replace by vn. So vn square. This equation for radius nth orbit. Radius of nth orbit. Okay. This vn we can substitute here. So what will be rn? Rn is equal to e square by 4 pi epsilon 0 m into. We need a vn square. This is vn. We need to square this. We will get n square h square divided by 4 pi square m square rn square. So m square rn square. Okay. Now this I need to take to numerator. Rn is equal to e square into 4 pi square m square rn square, the whole divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 m n square h square. Okay, here we can cancel a few terms. After cancelling a few terms, you will have rn is equal to e square, 4 cancels, 1 m cancels, okay, 1 pi cancels, you will get e square pi m rn square by epsilon 0 n square h square. Now on both sides there is rn. Rn here, here also r. One rn cancel. You have left one here. Here rn is left. So what is rn from this? Rn is equal to cross multiplying epsilon 0 h square n square by, we can say, pi m e square. This is the general equation for radius of the nth orbit, because it contain only constant terms except n square. I'll give equation number 6. So this is the radius of nth orbit. Epsilon 0 is a constant. H square is a constant. Pi m e square, all values are constants. Okay. So these constants we can put, substitute. Instead of these constants, we can substitute a symbol r0. The r0 is called a Bohr radius of first orbit. Okay. I will say rn is equal to r0 n square. R0 is called a Bohr radius. Bohr radius. What is the value of Bohr radius? Bohr radius has a value. R0 is equal to 5.3 into 10 raised to minus 11 meter. Okay. So this is the value of R0. R0 is called a Bohr. When you substitute these values, when you substitute the values of epsilon 0 h square by pi m e square, we will get this value. This is called Bohr radius. Bohr radius corresponds to the innermost. The radius of the innermost orbit is called a Bohr radius. So generally we have got equation Rn is equal to R0 into n square. This term is called R0. Okay, that's called a Bohr radius. Okay, so we have the total energy, then radius, Bohr radius. We have an equation for radius of the electron in the nth, radius of the orbit of the, radius of the nth orbit. Okay, so this is the equation. Rn is equal to epsilon 0 h square n square by pi m e square. Okay. Now, we need to get equation for total energy. This we need to get in terms of these constant values. How will you get? We have got the equation for E, total energy. We'll modify the equation in terms of nth orbit. For nth orbit, we can write equation En is equal to minus E square by 8 pi epsilon 0. I can say Rn. This R is modified to R. Okay. Now, what is En? Total energy in nth orbit, En is equal to minus E square by 8 pi epsilon 0. What is Rn? Rn has a value here. Substituting epsilon 0 h square n square by pi m e square. Okay, pi cancels. Okay, now rearranging, En is equal to, this I take to numerator, e square and e square e raised to 4, so I will get minus m is there in the numerator, minus m e raised to 4 by 8 epsilon 0 square h square n square. This equation for total energy of an electron in the nth orbit, total energy. Okay, so we have got equation for total energy. That's total energy is equal to minus m e raised to 4 by 8 epsilon 0 square h square n square. Okay, now similarly we can get equation for kinetic and potential energy. How can you get equation for kinetic and potential energy? To get kinetic energy, what we have to do is take this equation, okay, and substitute the value of R. We have R. So what is the kinetic energy? Or we can directly use this also to get kinetic or potential energy. Okay, so we know that kinetic energy is negative of what? Potential energy. So negative of total energy. This is total energy. When I take negative of this, what I will get? Kinetic energy. So what can I write? The kinetic energy, nth orbit. For nth orbit, the kinetic energy Kn. I can say Kn is equal to, and you take negative of this. So what will be the value? M e raised to negative positive by 8 epsilon 0 square h square n square. This is what? Kinetic energy. Okay. This I will give equation number 7. This I can give equation number 8. I have got kinetic energy also. Now to get potential energy, I need to multiply 2 here. Okay. When I multiply 2 here, 8 and 2 can divides, you will get 1 by 4 here. So then what will be the equation for potential energy? Un. For nth orbit, potential energy is equal to minus remains because 2 times E only, minus m e raised to 4 by 8 will be modified to 4 because we are multiplying 2 here. So 4 epsilon 0 square h square n square. This equation for what? This equation for total energy. Sorry, potential energy. So we have got equations for potential energy, kinetic energy, total energy, then the radius. In terms of constant values, these are constant values, m e raised to 4, all these are constant values. When you calculate the values of, when you substitute m e raised to 4, mass of electron, charge of electron raised to 4, 8, epsilon 0 is a constant value, h is a constant value, when you substitute, we can see that these constant values have a total value, that is minus 13.6. So we can simplify like this, En is equal to minus 13.6. We have to convert electron volt by dividing electronic charge. So divide by n square is already there. This will be in EV. So this is a general equation for energy of an electron in nth orbit. En is equal to minus 13.6 by n square EV. Okay. Now we have a few more equations left. So this is total energy. Now we need to get we need a velocity and time period. Velocity and time period of electron which are revolving in nth orbit. So to get velocity, we can use this equation Vn. Okay. In this Vn, Rn we have to substitute from there. So what is Vn now? Vn is equal to nh by 2 pi m into, what is Rn there? Epsilon 0 h square n square from here. Rn by pi m e square. Pi m cancels. Okay. This e square comes to numerator. What is Vn? Vn is equal to 1 n also cancels here. Okay. So we'll get h e square. E square h. Okay. E square into h. And what is left here? 2 is there. 2 epsilon 0 h square n. This equation for velocity of nth orbit. Here also, sorry, 1H cancels, okay? This H also cancels. So we don't have the H. E square by 2 epsilon 0 H into N. Pi already cancelled, okay? So this is the equation for what? Nth velocity of nth orbit. Now if this is the velocity, we have time period. What is time period? The time taken by the electron to make one complete revolution. We can have equation for time period. Time is equal to circular path. It is moving in circular path 2 pi r by velocity. So what is nth time period in nth orbit? 2 pi r n by vn. So we can say t is equal to 2 pi. What is r n? We have epsilon 0 h square n square by pi m e square. Now what is vn? We have got vn here. Vn is equal to e square by 2 epsilon 0 n into h. 2 epsilon 0 n into h. Now we need to simplify this. Okay. When you simplify this, we'll get equation for time period. This is the equation of velocity. We can give a number for this question, equation number 9. Now we need to simplify this. Okay. Before simplifying, we need some space. So we can write the simplification here. Okay, now simplifying, this pi cancels, 1 pi cancels, then I need to take this to a numerator, that is 2 into epsilon 0 h square n square into 2 epsilon 0 n h by pi, so pi is cancelled, m is left here, e raised to 4, m e raised to 4. Now what will be this equation after simplifying? Tn is equal to, you have a 2 epsilon 0 square, okay, h square and h cube, then n also cubed, n square and n cube h cube by m e raised to 4. This is equation for what? Equation for time period. Time period of electron which is revolving in nth orbit. This is equation number 10. So we have got many equations for the hydrogen atom. First, we have got a general formula of kinetic energy, potential energy, total energy, taken to radius, general equation for radius. Then we have taken to nth orbit, radius of nth orbit we have got. Then continuously we have got the general equation for radius of nth orbit. Then total energy in nth orbit we have got. With the help of these equations, total energy, potential and kinetic energy, this is the value of total energy. Then we have got values of velocity in nth orbit and time period in nth orbit. Okay, so in the next session we will see the atomic spectra of hydrogen atom. Okay, thank you.